Help me welcome with your listening ear, Victoria Catherine, to the studio. Hey, lady, what's up?
Hey.
How are you?
I'm good.
Good. Thank you for coming in.
Well, you're very welcome.
So, Victoria Catherine is your pen name?
Yes.
How did you choose Victoria Catherine?
Victoria Catherine was my imaginary friend growing up, and I still have her. She's kind of like, I guess you call her my Sasha Fierce.
Okay.
So when I, like, even doing this or the book fair.
Okay.
That's not something I would normally do.
Okay.
So I say that she's the one that signs me up for these things.
From Victoria Catherine from Fort Wayne by way of Chicago.
Yes.
She is an erotic adult romance writer. She published 4 novellas since 2015 and has a short story compilation releasing in 2019.
Yes.
So since 2015, 4?
Yes.
You're
yes.
a busy woman. Oh, wait a minute. Victoria Catherine is a busy woman.
Yes, Victoria Catherine, quite busy, yes.
Tell me who Victoria Catherine is and tell me about you.
Originally I started, I've always written poetry, everything like that, but, and it all started when I was young, and my grandmother and my great aunt, they would share what we would call naughty books back in the day. Like, she'd hide them under her bed. And
you so go sneak and read them.
I would. So I'd sneak under the bed and I'd read them. And I always thought I could do this. So as a young kid, I'm sitting there trying to write, you know, like heaving bosom. And it was horrible. But it just always got me interested in that. And it got me interested in the psychology of romance and people mm-hmm. and how do people fall in love? Why do people want to do these things? So and then I just kind of put it away. I got more into visual art and things like that in college. So my major was liberal arts with a visual art concentration. And then about 2014, one of my really good college friends, years after college, she was doing NaNoWriMo in November.
Okay.
And she said, I'm going to write a novel in 30 days. And I'm like, what? You are married. You got kids. How are you going to do that? And she did it. And so I was like, okay, I'm married. I got kids. So I can do this. So, you know, I hit her up and I said, I think I can do it. She's like, go for it. So her name is
Did she give you any pointers?
She did. Oh, my gosh. She let me. I just hopped on her Facebook Messenger like, Eliza, help me. Eliza Davis, she also indie publishes. So I geared up and I didn't do NaNo that year. But right after, I started writing and I didn't think that it would work. And all of a sudden, this story just poured out. So my first novella was called One. And then I got pregnant. And so I said, okay, that's it. I'm never writing again. I can't do it. And then had the baby. And then I was like, I'm going to do 2. So I wrote the follow-up, 2. And that's when after that, Milk the Honey came. That was a compilation. And then I came out about 2 years ago as bisexual. So I thought it was, I didn't come out with a bang. You know, there was no sparkle or confetti or like, oh, I'm out. It was kind of like, okay, yeah, I'm bisexual, next. And I thought, but that's still an interesting story when you are 36, married, children, nothing emphatically changes,
mm-hmm.
but it's still a change and you still want to say what you are and live in your truth. So that's when the book, I Guess I'm Out, was written. So that's loosely based on me just saying, okay, I'm out, like, and next. So, yeah.
Now, is that with your pen name as well?
Yes. Mm-hmm. All of them under my pen name.
How do you manage the writing, the wife, the
I have
mom?
My husband. He's amazing. So when because I'm not a disciplined writer. I will say that flat out. I'm not a writer that says I write every Saturday. I write every, you know, this day. I write when I feel like it. So if we're in the middle of doing something and I'm like, I got to write. He's like, okay. Go write, and he'll wrangle the kids, and he's like, I got dinner, and he'll let me write. And sometimes I write for 20 minutes, sometimes I write for 4 hours. So he's been that person to, and if I get down, if I'm like, I'm not writing again, I can't do it. It's just because you get what we call plot bunnies. You want to write about everything. Every single thing is a story. So you get so many in a notebook, and you're like, I'm never going to write these. And he's the one that tells me,
Slow down, just write.
Wow. And so, and then when it comes to finishing, so he helps me with our covers. So I do my own covers. I do my own trailers, all the promotion. He helps
me
with
that. So you are self-published.
I am definitely self-published, and I self-publish under my own publishing company, Write for Whiskey Press. So, yeah.
Does that start with the 2015 books, the self-publishing?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Why did you choose self-publishing over traditional publishing?
Because I am an African-American woman, and I know how hard it can be for any writer to get the attention, because there's so many writers out there to get the attention. And I thought to myself, you know what? I don't have to fight this. I want to write. I want to publish. I can just do it myself. If somebody likes it, they want to pick me up, great. If they don't, I got it myself. So, I mean, I just figured, why not do it myself? And my other friends were doing it themselves. So, you know, I definitely tapped into Eliza, tapped into a friend of mine, Ray Ford, and said, how do we do this? They showed me how, and it's actually pretty easy. It's a little stressful for your first book, but after that, it's pretty easy, and it's just all about self-promotion.
So your publishing company only publishes sensual novels?
For right now, yes.
Okay.
Who knows what will come up later? I have dabbled in some other work before and wondered, do I put that under my legal name? Should I pick another name? Because people will think, you know, Victoria Catherine is just erotica. But who knows? Yeah, I'm pretty free-wielding about it. But they are available on Amazon, so you can always pick one up.
There you go. Give us your contact information.
All right, so I am on Amazon, of course, under Victoria Catherine. I love the idea of ebooks. Don't get me wrong, I love having a paperback book in my hand.
Okay.
But in this day and age of people kind of needing that instant gratification, I do really push my ebooks, and plus they're only 99 cents. So I always promote it as put one thing away at the Dollar Tree and buy my book. You're not doing anything today, buy my book. But that's me. You can always, my website is victoriacatherinewriter.com. And you can also, on that, you will find links to all of my books. You will find my blog, which I blog pretty much about anything because I'm a huge TV and movie watcher. So I'll blog about anything. And some of my poetry or free work, or a story that I know will never really turn into a book, but I'm kind of like, hey, why don't you should read it. And I also have links to, all, of course, all of my social media.
What makes you stand out? I want to, Victoria Catherine, what makes you stand out as a writer?
I would say that I walk the very fine line. One of my favorite writers is Emma Chase. And she writes more adult romance. Now, her stuff can get steamy. And then I have another writer that I love, Selena Kitt. Her stuff is really great, but also can be very vulgar. So I like to come right in the middle of that. So a person that might not want to go full throttle, but want a little bit more than your typical romance. And I've coined the term bathtub lit.
What does that mean?
I coined it because my books are novellas, so they're shorter. They run about 100 pages, and it's just enough for a person who wants to, they soak in the bath, they just want to read something kind of steamy, and they could read it, just parts or whatever, just in a nice bathtub, you know, just okay. Their own private, personal time. So, yeah. My daughter is begging me. She's like, write something that I can read. So I told her, I said, the only way that I would write something that she could read is if she writes it with me. So I've already got her started writing some plot monies. Because I said, no, if I write it, you got to write it with me. So
how old is she?
She just turned 8.
Oh, wow.
So yeah, she's ready and set to go.
What brought you to Fort Wayne? And were you writing when you were in Chicago?
I was writing more so poetry when I was in Chicago. What brought me to Fort Wayne was my husband. He's originally from Fort Wayne. And all he had to tell me was that the cost of living was cheaper. And I was like, okay, let's go.
Huh?
Yeah, it's close enough to Chicago. So when I want my good Chicago foods and things, it's easy to go back. Yeah.
Now, as a writer, do you ever get writer's block?
Oh, I live in writer's block. I absolutely live there.
And how do you move forward then?
Sometimes I force myself.
I don't think
out
so
of it.
Because you said, wait a second, I need to read this over. Since 2015, you've written 4.
Oh, yeah.
Written and published 4.
Yeah.
Well, your writer's block doesn't last very long.
You'd be surprised. I have friends that have written 10 in that period of time. I know, it's crazy.
I don't know what I'm doing wrong then.
But I think what I do sometimes, I just let it ride out. So I might take a full year to write a book. I'll write it in 3 months, but I haven't written anything for 7 months before that. Other times I force myself out and I'll just free write, where I'm not writing that story, but I will watch my neighbors or a person sitting in a car next to me and I'll write a story about them. Why are they at Walmart? What are they buying? Are they waiting for their boyfriend or a mistress? Or, you know, so I do that.
You just go there in your head.
It just goes there in my head. And then I'll sometimes jot it down just on my phone. And it just helps keep the juices flowing. And then eventually it's like, okay, I'm ready to write. So let's write.
That is very fascinating. And we talked about how you balance family. Did we talk about how you balance family? No, we did not.
No.
How do you balance family?
Well, like I said, with my husband, he really helps me balance. And my kids are great. My son is 2. He's going on 3. And like
I said, have a baby.
I got a baby. So, you know, and my daughter even knows when she, you know, when I say mommy's going to write, she's like, okay, I'm going to shut the door. You know, you write. Or sometimes she'll get on me. Have you written this week?
Aww.
And I'm like, no. She's like, well, go write something. So, and I just plan. I'm an over planner, which my family would tell you. Yes, I'm an over planner. So if I know I have a deadline, like sometimes I just put deadlines on myself.
Okay.
So once I've fully written a book, then that's when I get into, that's my favorite part. Like after the book is done and the editing is done, my favorite part is the putting everything together. So the cover, the promotion, all that kind of stuff. So I balance all of that out with carving out the time. And I took a leap of faith last year and I left my job. So now I'm a stay-at-home mom. So it makes it a little...
You're a full-time writer.
Yeah. So now it makes it a little easier for me to write. But actually, what's funny is that I actually could write more when I was working than when I'm home. Because when you're home, it never stops. Like, there's no lunch break. There's no...
And I bet you find other things to do.
Oh,
I
yeah.
need to vacuum the carpet.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Let me
oh,
get
you know,
dinner
I'm gonna do
ready.
That load of laundry. And you're just like, okay, now I need to write. Whereas when I was working, it was, you know, I'm going to stay an hour late at work and then punch something out. But now it's like, no. So I do have to focus. And when I get overwhelmed, I just tell my husband, like, got to write. And he's like, okay, let's figure
awesome.
That out. Yeah.
Good for you.
Thanks.
Good for you. For aspiring writers and publishers,
mm-hmm.
What would you suggest? Pointers would you give?
For aspiring writers, I would say, one, just write. Don't try to fit into a genre yet. If you haven't, like if you don't know what genre you want, just start writing and you'll figure out your genre. If you want to self-publish, go ahead. It's fine. If you want the standard publishing, that's okay too, but you can still self-publish and also pitch.
How do you start that journey of self-publishing?
Well, the first thing you do is most of us go through Amazon, of course. So you, I think they've changed it up a little bit, but you just go through a KDP.com. And you upload your book and they will give you everything. They give you the formatting, how your book should look. And they do it both for paperback and ebook.
Mm-hmm.
They are the ones that do all the distribution and everything. So once you upload it and get your cover, then it's uploaded. It's good to go. But I would tell people the main thing for aspiring writers is it's good to invest in an editor.
That's what I was just going to ask.
All, especially indie authors have gone through it. You publish your book, you're so excited, you read through it and you're like, oh, I found the biggest typo. And you just want to hide under covers. And then eventually you're like, okay, it's fine. And you can always go back in and edit and say, okay, maybe only 10 people bought that with that in there. Yay, okay.
How do you find a good editor?
There's I mean, online is huge.
Okay.
You just have to make sure that they're credible, reliable. And they do charge, and that you will pay. And it's because you want a good editor. Don't ever think, you know, if somebody says, you know, oh, I can do it for $50. You know, and there's different kinds of editors too. I mean, you have ones that just do strictly grammar. Then you have the ones that break down your story and want you to bring out a character.
Thank you. That's helpful.
And things like that. So, it all depends on what you can afford, what you need. And
knowing what you're searching for.
Exactly.
Because I've never heard of that there are different types of editors.
Oh, yeah. My final thought would be I am an asocial introvert. I mean, completely.
Are you really?
I am. Everybody says that. That is the... if you can see her face right
you
now.
You get this look. Yeah, I'm like, really?
That's the face I always get. And it takes a lot for me to do things like this, even to write and to publish. But even as an introvert, even as somebody who would rather just stay under a blanket, there's a gratification when you get your voice out there and you can do it how you see fit. So I have friends. I have a friend of mine, Eliza David. She's a fellow author. She is extrovert and she's amazing. And I follow around like in her shadow, like, ooh, what'd you do? Oh, you did that? Oh, that's awesome. I could never do that. And then there's days where I'm like, I can totally do that. So I didn't, even with this, I didn't tell anybody at first that I was going to do it. And then when they told me.
You mean to come on the radio?
Both, radio
oh, the writing,
and the fair.
And the writing, okay.
Oh my goodness. Like both of these things. Yeah. So once I got on, I was excited and everything. And I even told my husband, yeah, you know, once it's over, I'm going to just like lay on the floor. And but just put yourself out there and you can do it in your own time. You can do it in your own way. You don't necessarily have to scream it out, but you can do it at your own pace. And I have friends who write and who publish that never promote. They don't care. They just like to know that they've published.
How do you get it out then? How do
they
sell it?
Oh, social media is your friend.
Okay.
Yeah. And I would say Twitter is your biggest friend because you meet a lot of authors on Twitter.
Yeah, you do.
A ton. I've met so many. And so Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, those are the big ones.
Give us your contact information.
Oh, I did. It's VictoriaCatherineWriter.com and it's Tori at VictoriaCatherineWriter.com. That's my email. You can always contact me straight through the website.
Wow. Final thought, sweetie.
I say my final thought would be come out tomorrow. I'll be signing the books. I will have candy because it's awesome. And that I hope that even the ones that can't make it out or are not in town, you can always visit Amazon under Victoria Catherine and find my books. All right.
You are listening to Speak Now, jamming with my jazz at 95.7 FM WELT.